sum omnium plausu decidi ut illustrissima domina Patricia Pucci in corpus doctorum universitaris honoris causa reciperetur in cuius rei fidem hoc diploma conscribendum censuit Cesar Ion Spânu, rector magnificus. Datum Craiove, die docimo mensis octobris, anno domini, bis millesimo, decimo sexto.
As I said, I love to mention among his best students, Professor Kabiri Andreyan, who now is professor in Bucharest, a woman like me. The second one is Professor Ciprian Foyas, awarded by the Wiener Prize in Applied Mathematics in 1995 for his contribution in operator theory, who was professor at the prestigious universities of Bucharest, Paris 11, at the Indiana University, and since 2000, Professor Foyas is a distinguished professor at the Texas A&M University, and is listed as the highly cited researcher. Professor Dan Virgil Voiculescu, a former student of Professor Foyas, professor since 1987 at the University of California in Berkeley, and great expert in operator and probability theory. Professor Voiculescu started his career at the University of Bucharest, then at the Institute of Mathematics of the Romanian Academy. Professor Voiculescu received the 2004 NIS Award for Mathematics from the National Academy of Sciences for his achievements in the theory of free probability, and he was elected a member of the National Academy of Sciences in 2006. I mean, incredible. Professor George Lustig, who is a professor at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, is a member of the Royal Society since 1983, and of the National Academy of Sciences since 1992. Professor Lustig was the Cole Prize in Algebra in 1985, received the Brouwer Medal in 1999, and the Le Steele Prize for Lifetime Achievement in Mathematics in 2008. In 2014, Professor Lustig received the Shaw Prize in Mathematics. Last but not least, I desire to mention my dear forever friend, Professor Vincenzo Radulescu, who is one of my truest friends and greatest supporters, and gave generously his time and knowledge to me since I met him. Professor Radulescu of this university is a fellow of the Simon Style of Mathematics Institute of the Romanian Academy since 2007, and highly cited members by the Thomson Reuters. He is a corresponding member of the Accademia Peloritana dei Pericolanti of Messina since May 2016. Professor Radurescu wrote as editor together with James Serin, who was the honorary editor, and Enzo Mitidieri, the recent the recent trends in several lines are missing, so I do apologize. It's not my original. Okay, I will do this. So in these nonlinear evolution problems of these stationary and also evolution problems, which appeared in 2013 and was a collection of more than 700 pages concerning the proceedings of the workshop that held from May 28 to June 1, 2012 at the University of Perugia in honor of my 60th birthday, a very appreciated birthday gift, I would say. I wrote jointly with Vincenzo Radulescu and Heinz Weinberger the two-volume set of the James Serin selected papers, which appeared in 2014. This experience was for me the most exciting adventure of my mathematical life. I am a Perugian mathematician in the most complete way. I was born in Perugia, graduated under the supervision of Professor Calogero Vinti, and made almost my whole career at the University of Perugia. I love my Etruscan city from the bottom of my heart. Professor Calogero Vinti had the closest scientific and personal contacts with Lamberto Cesari, laurea honoris causa and frequent visitor of my university, so that after I graduated in 1975, I started working under the supervision of Lamberto Cesari, and I visited the University of Michigan several times. Actually, I was almost adopted by Isotta and Lamberto Cesari. After Cesari's death, I've been among the founding members of the Centro Studi Interfacoltà Lamberto Cesari at the University of Perugia in 1995. But my formation as a mathematician was greatly influenced by James Serin. A very large part of my research life was connected with him. I attended James Serin courses beginning with his SANFA 4 seminars in Naples in March 1980, but I was introduced to him by Lamberto Cesari at the University of Michigan. Few months later, in August 1980, during the conference on the occasion of the Cesari's retirement. Professor Serin was already a giant in the subject of partial differential equations, of fluid mechanics, and of thermodynamics. His fundamental contribution, especially in real analysis and in the calculus of variations were already well known and often cited in Italy since the 1960s. In 1981, Lamberto Cesari invited James Herring to the conference held in Bologna to celebrate the 70th birthday of Cesari in Italy. On that occasion, during conversation along Via Zamboni, the famous street of the Met Institute, Lamberto told me to attend the course that James was going to deliver at the Smil School in Cortona, in this beautiful palace of a Count of Italy, and at the same time asked James to propose to me some topics on which I could report at the summer school. Presenting such reports was a teaching tool for the young mathematicians at the advanced courses in Cortona. In August 1981, James Herring and Lawrence Craig Evans gave a course at the Cortona Summer School, and James gave me some papers on elliptic overdetermined problems and on the mountain pass theorem by Ambrosetti and Paul Rabinowitz. This was the starting point of my long, fruitful collaboration with James. At that time, I was only an assistant professor, and in 1983, I got a position as associate professor at the University of Perugia, while in 1987, I became full professor at the University of Modena. James came from frequent visits in both towns, delivering unforgettable, exceptional lectures until 2012, when he died. Since this Cortona lecture, I continued to learn much from him at his remarkable seminars held year after year. I just recall his masterly courses in Milan in 1982 and in Varenna in 1983. James always devoted a surprising amount of time and effort to young mathematicians, giving mathematical consultations even to people unknown to him. Between 1984 and 2012, we wrote more than 40 papers and a monograph on the maximum principle together. I just quote only the best known papers that I listed here, which inspired other work and which we liked very much. At the end of writing one of these papers, James and I used to celebrate the event by going out with his wife Barbara to some Italian restaurants in Minneapolis. It was lovely, really and truly, to celebrate with Barbara, since without her patience, help, and hospitality, I could never have written all these joint papers with James. In June 2004, the Accademia Nazionale dei Lincei awarded the prize Professor Luigi Tartufari for Mathematics to my research work. The committee was made up by Professors Enrico Magenes, who was the president of the committee, Carlo Cercignani, Claudio Procesi, Sergio Spagnolo. I don't have any picture, but I just put the picture of a Scuola Normale Superiore in Pisa, and Antonio Ambrosetti, my supervisor of the prize. Well, the committee assigned the prize by a detailed report in which essentially my work with James was quoted. I was very happy and honored, but also James was very glad and proud of me. I will never forget the marvelous words he told me when I called him and let him know about the prize. Few days after, we celebrated this fact with Barbara on the occasion of the workshop on the new developments in nonlinear partial differential equation, which we organized with Filippo Gazzola in Minneapolis, and then in September 2004 in Italy, when we went to commemorate with a dinner all the most beautiful restaurant, at the most beautiful restaurant in my area. A grateful tribute I desire to address to Antonio Ambrosetti, whose guidance, encouragement, and achievements will shine brightly on me forever. Professor Ambrosetti was the national coordinator of my Italian team in the MUIR project, Variational Methods on Nonlinear Differential Equations, started by Ambrosetti in 1999 and continuously founded by MUIR until its end in 2009. To belong in this team has been being us to be in a warm, lovely family, protected and helped in any moment. I organized with Professor Ambrosetti the most popular, interesting workshops in Perugia and in Grado, full of young, clever, deep mathematicians. A great, unforgettable time. My long association with James Herrin has been for me a wonderful experience, and the great master was for me above all a steady friend since I met him in 1980. He was an enthusiastic organizer of the May conference held at Perugia in 2012 on the occasion of my 60th birthday, where several of our best friends and colleagues on PDEs came from all over the world and gave brilliant talks, as Professor Radulescu. The speakers celebrated not only me, but also James, addressing special words to him with sincere affection and profound esteem. Even though, at the time of the conference, he was already not well, he attended all the talks and delivered an exceptional, unforgettable opening lecture. His presence in Perugia at the conference was for me the most appreciated gift I received for my 60th birthday. Mr. Rector, Mr. Vice Rectors, dearest colleagues, dearest students, ladies and gentlemen, let me end with my warmest expression of thanks for the great honor I have to get the doctor honoris causa at the University of Craiova, and in a country so full of great mathematicians, as I started my talk. A country, Romania, which includes Roma in its name. All of you can imagine what this means for me. Whenever I will go from now on, I will say to have received this great honor from the University of Craiova, and I am really proud to be your ambassador. Thank you very much.
Am avut onoarea de a oferi astăzi o altă distincție a Universității unui excelent om de știință, dar în același timp am avut ocazia să celebrăm ceea ce matematica înseamnă, ceea ce aduce ea în cunoașterea umană. Matematica este nu numai un limbaj de strictă specialitate, construit pentru uzul unui grup restrâns de cunoscători, ci este o chintesență a gândirii pure, cu un farmec și o poezie aparte. Doamna profesoară lucrează cu ecuații, iar ecuațiile au fost de foarte multe ori asemănate cu poeziile. Frumusețea, modul în sine de a gândi în matematică se aseamănă cu modul în sine plin de semnificații pe care îl întâlnim în poezie. Dear Professor Pucci, thank you for making us understand once more that mathematics is not only science, but can be also beautiful and enlightening. You brought us the vision of a scientist on the unbelievable power of the mathematical language. You offered to the non-specialists, as a part of us are here, the chance of understanding the poetry of mathematics. You work with equations, and the equation from science touch us somehow in the same way that the best poems do it. In a poem, we are surprised by how many meanings can be compressed in a single phrase. The equation from science concentrate in one formula an entire world, sometimes the entire universe. They take us behind the mirror of the scientific truth and allow discovering the beauty of nature. They help people to open the eyes to new words and to new ways of thinking. If I am allowed to cite Bertrand Russell, mathematics possess not only truth, but supreme beauty. The scientific equation can be as moving as poetry, as mysterious as magic, and as aesthetic as the finest art. I will finish my short speech citing from another very famous scientist, the Nobel Prize laureate, Steven Weinberg. He said, "It is terribly difficult for us to put ourselves in the frame of mind of those who lived in the past centuries. But many of their artifacts, buildings, roads, works of art have survived. In the same way, it is often hard for us to understand the thinking of the past scientists who did not know what we know, the great equations of the nature. These equations are monuments of the scientific progress, just as cathedrals are monuments of the spirit of the Middle Ages." As a conclusion, please, Professor Pucci, accept our deep respect for what you do and what you mean in this fascinating world of equations. Thank you very much for being here and for accepting this special prize of us.